See what you've done? You've created a monster. First of all, I do some of these videos in response to comments, and I keep forgetting to write down who made the comments, so please don't feel like I'm ignoring you or slighting you in any way. I'm old, and I forget, and I drink vodka, so... Anyway, this video is in response to someone who commented asking about how you can even start downsizing your life. Because you look around and you've got shit everywhere. And I gotta tell you, I understand that. I had a 2,000 square foot, three bedroom, two bath house with a screened in pool and a 12 or 14 by 20 Florida room. And I had shit everywhere. So to make this short and sweet, the way I did it was just like everybody else. You're going to buy your camper before you sell your house, because what are you going to do? Live in a Maytag box, you know? So you're going to have something. So what I did was I took the clothes, the utensils, the entertainment that I needed if I was going to go on a between a 2 week and a 1 month trip somewhere. If I was going to take this camper and I was just going to travel around for 2 months, what did I need? And I found out that that's all I needed. The only difference was in the clothes, because you have summer clothes and you have winter clothes. So I put, say it was in the summer, I put my winter clothes in space bags, and I used a vacuum cleaner and sucked them all down so they're about this big and shoved them underneath the bed in the little storage unit there. And then in the wintertime, pull those out, take the summer clothes, fold them up, put them in there, suck the air out of them, and whoosh. But aside from that, that's all I needed. Basically, I needed 2 weeks worth of stuff. I mean, I've got pots and pans so I can cook. I've got silverware. I've got enough clothes for, you know, 2 weeks. There are laundries out there. And even if there aren't, you can get one. You know, I mean, I'll show you in another video. I have one of those base camp washing machines and a laundry alternative dryer that I use in the shower when I, you know, I pull them out when I take a shower and I put them back in there, and it works perfect. Now, I realize that a lot of you have sentimental things. I've got great grandma's rocking chair and I cannot bear to part with it, but you don't have room in the camper. So get yourself a storage unit or find a relative that has storage space you can put that kind of stuff in, and you'll do okay. It's not that hard. I really thought it was. I'm looking at all of this. I found, just as an aside, when I was going through the boxes in my garage, I found boxes that I had dragged from New York to Florida, back to New York, back to Florida, out to Las Vegas, and back to Florida, and I never opened them. I opened some of these boxes, and there was stuff in there from 25 years ago, and I couldn't remember what it was. The only box that meant anything to me was a box of photographs. So I scanned them in, digitized them, put them on a couple CDs, and then either gave them away or threw them out, because I had them. If I need to print them, I can always print them again. And I'd rather look at pictures on a TV screen than flip through a book anyway. So for me, it was easy. Ultimately, it's not that hard. The big thing is up here. The big thing is, what do I need versus what do I want versus what can I not part with, even if I don't need or want it. Once you get past that, it's not that hard. But start out thinking you're going to go away for 2 weeks and packing the camper for a 2 week trip, and you're going to find that everything else is going to become stuff and not mean that much, and it's going to make your life a lot simpler. That's it. Thanks.